Alright, so we just made our crude kitchen. Our base just ranked up to level 2. We just got a save in here. Now let's gonna continue on with these quests. Which is this guy. He's gonna be like, oh, you just made a kitchen. And he wants some grub. Which is why I've been collecting all those mushrooms. He's a fatty. Shelf. Yeah, what that. There's your next seed of life. And I know how to make a pot. Yay. Now we're up to 55. So, a really useful thing to have. What these pots are good for is they're good for leveling your base early game. You can make rooms just because they're called pot rooms, and they're basically just point space fillers, point fillers. Let's put another chair chest. We're gonna need a chair chest for that room. Alright, we're gonna need some torches actually. Need a door. That's what I forgot to build. Maybe they just randomly built me one. Nope. Yeah, sure, I'll fight him. Let's do it. Since I actually talked to you already. No biggie. The battle begins. That side. Back about my wall, I say. Punch you. About the essay. Whooped on him. What are these fools doing? Freeze! That's what they're doing, they're luring me away. That's a good thing to get. That's good. We got some cloth. You don't want to get those. while. Not until the next place meeting, because there was a demo. This was the only chance to get them. So, apparently by doing that fight, our light increased. So the light goes out to those rocks right there. I'm gonna see if it expanded somewhere. A blue tab of fragments. We already got the thing. Let's check that. It did. It went one block further. The line ended right here. Now the light goes out one further because I measured from these rocks here because it ended on these rocks. So it does go one out further. That's cool. Our base actually did expand, so we can make the walls one further out all the way around the perimeter. That's pretty nice. Make the teleport though. Yeah, we can do it. Just make as many as we can of those. Always want some more of those. I think I was making a door. I needed a door. Make one really quick. Let's make two more of those. I feel like we've gone through some of those. I need it for the pop chamber. So that'll just rack up some points there. Everyone's so amazed at the pot chamber. So this destination is where we are able to acquire the hammer. The hammer, you can get that. That's when you can get, you can knock down trees and get better materials. Fantabulous. I'm gonna put it too close to the door because I don't want to accidentally go through the teleportal. Put it down in here. Got a decent spot, I guess, for it. You can move it maybe later. See about that. Yeah, you can break it. Thank you. Yeah, you can stay here for a while. Not mind, though. Not mind. So, what we're gonna do here? Put that away. Our knife is here. We need that dirt. Because there is a tower. That way. On top of that tower there is the seed of life that is going to get us to chapter 1's max health of 60. Not that far away. You just need some dirt blocks to stack your way to the top. Not too bad. And what's cool is once we get our hammer, we're able to get the magic box, which allows you to, if your inventory bar down here is full, that's your max capacity within our backpack. But the magic box is when your inventory is full, if you pick something off the floor, it'll automatically just go to your box instead of not being able to pick it up because your inventory is full. So it basically solves that problem, which is extremely helpful. What's this ghost doing? Yeah, you ain't nothing. Come at me. Nothing too, come here. I know it. Come at me too. Hey, then what, man? Good, break that. Just break that. Come up around here like that. And there's no other way for us to get up there, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna build our way up there. Our next seed of life. That puts us at 60 health, which is just fantastic. Like I said before, my goal is to punch out the dragon with my bare fists. I see this going very well in my favor. Not both of them. Man, they were getting me though. These fireballs. Don't play around with that. I remember what I wanted to do as well. I wanted to find some healing cream. Some more healing cream. I wanted to find one of the little tree stump crafting tables that are just laying out here, places, random places. I want to take that with us because over the mountain where the dragon is, there's not one over there, and this will come ahead if you run out of weapons or I'm gonna do a bare fist, I'm not worried about weapons, but if you run out of healing potion or something, you wanna run over there really quick and, you know, mash up on some healing potions. In fact, while I'm up here, I can actually show you guys the little dips that I was talking about. You can also press your options button and you can look up on top here. So that little crater there, you could probably break that one open. like this crater here, you can come in here with your hammer and you just smash straight down it, and sometimes it'll open up into a little chamber with just a single treasure chest in there. It's not a deep cavern or anything. This crater here you could probably break open, or that one, that section right there. You just want to come through this mountain and you know, you start, you literally just start smashing things. And there's a lot of secret chambers in this mountain, and they all have seeds of life in them. The more HP you got, the better chance of survival. So they're going towards this way. It reveals the treacherous dragon over there. That's the one we're going to slay with our bare fists, like men. These are other little things that you can collect. Oh, there's different terrain over there. There's so many materials over here around the dragon. It's just ridiculous. Like, you can't help but just go bananas through this field and ravage all of its goods. Now, if you're done, you know, you got your Chimera Wing ready to go. Straight back to the base. This is why I brought my crafting tree table, which is a good thing to have when you come over here, because you're going to want to churn in these materials, possibly save you some extra space in your inventory by churning them into materials like healing potions and things like that, which means you can carry more stuff. And that the item that dragon drops, you know, if you want to carry that, you know, you want to have the space to do so. So many mushrooms around here, oh my goodness. I'm gonna be able to cook up so much. I'm gonna be stocked up for a while, guys. Which is definitely good. Definitely good. All the white flowers around here. That's basically the game's way of telling you to stock up on healing potions. That's exactly what that means. Scavenger's land for the last of its goods over here. This is just all this food again, which is going to be below 10%, so you don't gotta waste one of your 20%. Get those up to the full health, and the more health you have as well, you'll actually heal. If you're not in battle for so long, you'll actually start healing based on your hunger. If you're full, start to heal. Thank you.
control of that white little thing does. It's nothing special. I'm trying to hold on to it. It plants white flowers. It's usually so you can get the flowers. Like if you want to plant them inside your base decoration, I think it gives you some points if you plant them in the base, but I use it for healing potions for now. It's not like they're like a limited source that I need to save. I actually almost full on these baton berries, so I can actually stop grabbing these here pretty soon. Random pot here, if you want to, you know, if you want to grab that one. There's no point, but since we already have a pot room, our villager will go in there and just create pots so you can go in that treasure chest that we put in there and just collect. That mushroom is just sitting over here. Alright, let's start moving on the top here. I think we got all the perimeter items. Dragon is this way, so we're going this way. We're going to start making our way towards him and taking out all his materials around his base really quick, and then we're gonna try to punch him to death. Just because that seems like a cool achievement to do. Like, I don't think anyone's gonna attempt that. Why would anyone want to do that? So actually, this is a good place to put this thing over here, right next to the dragon. It's not too much in the way. But we're gonna just clear out a whole thing for those. We're not gonna make anything else, though. Nothing else really good that we can make. We only got six white lily pads over there. I'm actually using my fist right now because my thing is broken. I don't want to plant a new one or break a hole, go through a whole new one. Well, I could. I could just always unequip it later because I don't want to take a long time doing this. We want to get to the battle already. I accidentally hit the dragon. I completely just ruined my whole, like, concept of... defeating him without hitting him with a weapon. If you do leave him alone, he will go back to sleep. It's not really a big deal. organize those.
What we're going to do is we're going to unequip these.
No, we're not ready. I changed my mind. I take that back. We need to heal up. Can't go into this foolish, guys. Now we can battle. I challenge you to a duel.
Fooled you, dragon. Thought you had me.